When I was approached about this project, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, I was so excited because one of my favorite books as a child was this book, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. And we watched the movies. I was the witch and my dog was the lion one Halloween. So this was a really exciting project, and getting to make a giant puppet of Aslan was even more exciting. I am a puppeteer and I get to make puppets all the time, but nothing this big. So I was super excited to have the opportunity to construct a massive lion. And we discussed, does it need to be a one-person lion, a two-person lion? Could it be three people? We settled on two people, which I think is just right because it's the perfect size for a lion. Now, of course, the first thing we started doing was looking at images and research. That's the best place to start at any project. So we looked at pictures of real lions, we looked at sculptures of lions, and we found this gorgeous metallic lion sculpture made of teeny tiny slivers of steel or aluminum. And all three of us, David and Anna G and I, all really fell in love with that image. And so we decided to see if we could evoke something more about Aslan if we made him a metal beast instead of like a really realistic lion. So we went with this metallic lion. So overall, it took about a year of discussing and planning and sketching, finding materials, researching to put him all together. And just the mane, for example, attaching the mane took about 10 hours. So he's a very, very time-heavy puppet, but I think it'll really pay off in the end.